One of these men is the commander of the largest rocket and missile launching base in the world. What is your name, please?
My name is Donald M. Yates.
What is your name, please?
My name is Donald M. Yates.
What is your name, please?
My name is Donald N. Yates.
Two of these people are imposters. Only one is the real Donald N. Yates and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now, here is our host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome once again to Tell the Truth. What is your name, please?
My name is Polly Bergen.
My name is Tom Yule.
My name is Kitty Carlisle.
And my name is High Gardner.
Now, these three people all claim to be Donald N. Yates. Only one of these gentlemen, of course, is the real Donald N. Yates. The other two have merely assumed his identity, and they do not have to stick to the truth. Now, panel, in front of you, you will find the customary copies of affidavits. Will you please find copy number one and follow along while I read it? I, Donald N. Yates, am a major general in the United States Air Force. I am a West Point graduate and won my pilot's wings at the old Air Corps Flying School at Kelly Field in Texas. Recently, my major interest has been in rockets and missiles. I am commander of the Air Force Missile Test Center Air Research and Development Command at Cape Canaveral, Florida. Signed, Donald N. Yates. Very well, panel. You heard these gentlemen all claim to be Donald N. Yates, commander of Cape Canaveral. Only the real Donald N. Yates, of course, is required to answer your questions truthfully. You will each question until you hear this signal. At the end of the questioning period, you will cast your vote for the one who, in your opinion, is the real Major General Yates. And we'll start tonight's first round with Polly Bergen. Polly?
Thank you, Bud. Number two, one of the larger Air Force bases is right outside Columbus, Ohio. Could you give me its name, please?
Actually, it's not at Columbus. It's closer to Dayton, and it's the Wright Air Force deal.
Number three, could you tell me the name of the large Air Force base right outside Columbus?
I think it's Wright-Patterson, you may mean.
Number one, what is your answer?
I think it's Wright-Patterson.
Number two, it wasn't.
It wasn't anything?
No, it wasn't the right field outside of Dayton.
None of them?
No.
May I suggest that you go back to questioning
the men? One of them's bound to be the right one. Number two, there are... how many of our satellites are in the air now?
We have three in the air at the present time.
Could you name them, please, number two?
One, two, and three.
Number three, could you name them?
I'm sorry, we have to go along now.
Oh, thanks, he was funny, man.
He was?
Yes.
Well, I'll have to go on anyway. Oh. Tom?
Thanks, Bud. Number one, what is the speed of Explorer number three? Number two, do you know what the speed of Explorer number three is?
The precise calculated speed is classified.
I see. Thank you. Number three, how long do they assume it will take a missile to circle the moon and return?
It should reach the moon in 2.5 days. The return problem is one we haven't considered yet.
Number three, what kind of fuel do you use in the big rocket?
Well, the liquid says LOX.
LOX? What's the other one, bagel?
That's the solid. Kitty Carlisle.
Number one, why of all places in the United States was Cape Canaveral chosen for these experiments?
Cape Canaveral was chosen primarily because of the group of islands down in the Caribbean, which would form bases from which we could observe the missiles as
I
they pass over.
Number two, you rocket people always count backwards, like, you know, 9, 8, 7. Why do you count that way?
It's the most logical mathematical method by which you can reach zero.
is nobody on the moon to tell us, when you get the rocket to the moon, how will you know when it got there? If it got there.
Well, by telemetry, by television, and by tape.
There you are.
Number one.
Okay, hi.
Number three, you mentioned LOX a moment ago. What is the three letters of LOX stand
Liquid
for?
Oxygen.
Make pardon?
Liquid oxygen.
And what's the X stand for?
Well, it's a short, it's an abbreviation of LOX.
Number two, would you answer that?
As it's ordinarily defined, liquid oxygen explosive.
Uh-huh. Number one, what is the name of the Army Air Base which services Cape Canaveral?
Patrick Air Force Base.
Time to vote, panel. Without consultation, will you please mark your ballots? And in so doing, of course, you will select, I trust, number one, number two, or number three. Team of challengers will get $250 for every incorrect vote. Okay, panel, have you voted? Polly, have you marked your ballot? Polly, are you marking your ballot?
Yes. Well, I voted for number three because number two didn't know the name of the three satellites that are up in the air. And I think it's number one because his pants were the most pressed. you know when they were standing up
yes,
there?
Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
And but maybe number three was just sitting down for a long time upstairs.
All right. Kitty, your vote, please. Oh, wait a minute. Tom, I'm sorry. Polly threw me.
Well, I voted for number one. I didn't notice his pants, but he put me in my place like a general generally does.
Now, Kitty?
I voted for number two based on very minuscule scientific knowledge and on his very military turn when he left the platform.
See? And Highgard.
Well, I picked number two primarily on the LOX answer, and I thought that first the general is probably the general, but I thought that wearing a mustache around naked likely to be a little bit inflammable.
All right, there we have it now, the way we have voted, and you will find out right now how right or wrong our panelists are this first round tonight as we discover which one of these three gentlemen is the commander of Cape Canaveral. So, will the real Donald N. Yates please stand up?
Yeah, I hear you.
There it is. You should have gone with your hat.
Major General, you always have good press pants.
That's
no
right.
Why I didn't go along?
You should have stuck with it, absolutely. Number two, would you tell us who you really are and what you do, please?
My name is Dr. J. Morrison Brady. I'm the chief of the Division of Field Medical Services for the National Foundation for Infantile Paralysis.
Thank you, sir. Polly, does Dr. Brady ring any bells with you?
Oh, my gosh. What, did he take out my appendix?
No.
What?
No, he put something back, or in, I should say. He gave you your first polio shot on the Guy Mitchell
show
remember. About a year and a half
I
ago.
Remember. There.
Now, number three, would you tell us who you are and what you do, please?
My name is Dick Halverson. I'm from Huntington, Long Island, and I'm a magazine writer.
Thank you, sir. One question, General, before we let you go. Last week, you conducted a very successful missile firing at Cape Canaveral. Would you tell us what was so very special about it?
I believe you refer to the Atlas firing.
Yes.
That was the first time that we had fired the ICBM Atlas with all three engines, and it was an extremely good flight.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear it. Well, you did better with that, I'm sure, than our panel did tonight. Only one got right. Three were incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $750 from Marlboro. Thanks very much, gentlemen. Pick up your carton of Marlboros on the way out. Good night and the best of good luck to you.
What is your name, please?
My name is Mary Blythe.
What is your name, please?
My name is Mary Blythe.
What is your name, please?
My name is Mary Blythe.
All right, panel, break it off and follow along with your copies of this affidavit, if you will, please. I, Mary Blythe, am a working girl. Unlike most working girls, however, I work 71 hours a week.
From 9 in the evening until 12:30 in the morning, six nights a week, I sing with a band in a nightclub. From 8 in the morning until 6 in the afternoon, 5 days a week, I work as a barber in a men's barber shop. Signed, Mary Blythe. Panel, in this round, you heard each of these young ladies claim to be Mary Blythe. I guess you might refer to her as a singing barber. Let's start this cross-examination with Hi Gardner. Hi.
Number two, what is your favorite song, The Barber of Seville or something?
Not exactly. I Concentrate on You is my very favorite.
Where, number two, do you work as a barber and also work in a nightclub? What city?
Wichita, Kansas.
Wichita, Kansas.
Yes.
Number one, what city do you perform both roles?
Tucson, Arizona.
It's a long way to commute between jobs. Number three, how long ago did the magazine Downbeat merge with the Barber's Journal?
I don't think it ever did.
You don't think so? Number three, what is a barber's, there's a thing that they pour or do something with, it's a liquid, it's called smoothie. Is it a tonic, is it a lotion, or is it a hair dye, would you know?
I haven't heard of smoothie.
Would you know number two?
No.
Number one?
No,
I've never heard of it.
Uh-huh.
Polly?
Thank you, but number three, what union do you belong to?
As a barber or as a singer?
As a barber.
I don't belong to any union as a barber.
Well, all right, what union as a singer then?
None.
Number three, have you ever been arrested for singing without belonging to a union?
No, I haven't.
You haven't? Where do you sing?
I sing at the Buena Vista Club in Cincinnati, Ohio.
What is the big radio station in Cincinnati, Ohio?
WLW.
What is the instrumentation of the band you work with?
It's a five-piece band.
Five-piece. Number two, how big is...
Tom Yule.
Thank you, bud. Number one, did you ever get mixed up and sing to the customer or shave the piano player? That was a bad... Number two, when you're shaving, do you put the cold towels on a man's face?
The cold towels? Well, most of my customers prefer hot towels. That opens the pores and makes for better shaving, etc.
I see. Thank you.
Didn't get away with that one.
No, I sure didn't. Number three, what is the biggest tip you ever got?
$5.
As a barber?
Yes.
Kitty? Number Kitty, Carla.
Number one, what's the name of the nightclub you sing in?
The Monta Vista in Tucson, Arizona.
And number two, what's the name of the nightclub you sing in?
The Alta Vista in Wichita, Kansas.
And you sing in the Buena Vista. when do you have time to rehearse with the band?
I don't. Usually we sing six nights a week.
So you don't rehearse at all?
No, that's
don't
about
need.
Enough.
Number two, when a musician says letter A, what does he mean?
Beg your pardon?
When a musician says letter A, what does he mean?
My musicians don't say that.
Do your musicians say that? Number three?
Sometimes.
And what do they mean?
Well, that's the letter on the music.
Which letter?
Letter A.
Uh-huh. We're getting nowhere.
You'll find with this young lady, they usually just say letter B. Okay, now our time is up for any further questions. It's time to vote without consultation, as usual. So would you mark your ballots and select number one, number two, or number three? Okay, all set, panel? Polly, for whom did you vote this time?
I voted for number three.
Oh, consistent.
And I have absolutely no reason whatsoever.
No pants pressed or nothing?
I just went eeny, meeny, miny, moe, and that's where she landed.
Don, what about your vote?
I voted for number two because she seems to be dressed for the evening shift.
And what about you, Kitty?
Well, I voted for number three. I didn't get a chance to ask number one what letter A meant, but number three did know that it was the thing on the music, so I voted for her.
Okay, and Hi Gardner.
Well, I also voted for number three. No reason excepting I think she looks a little bit less like Perry Como than anybody there.
Okay, there we have it. And this is the way we voted, and we have to stand by the way we just marked our ballot. So let's find out right now whether we're right or whether we're wrong as we discover which one of these ladies is the real singing Lady Barber. So will the real Mary Blythe please stand up. Number two, would you tell us who you really are and what you do, please?
Gray, and I am a consumer consultant at Peter Pan Foundation.
And number three, what about you?
I'm Eileen Martin Nichols. I'm from Long Island, and I'm a housewife.
Whoa, panel, they really fooled you this round, didn't they, huh? As counting up the score, we find that there were exactly four incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $1,000 from Marlboro ladies. Enjoy it, and on your way out, stop and pick up your individual cartons of Marlboros. Good night. Best of good luck to you all.
Thank
you. Now, panel, let's meet our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Reuben C. Thomas.
What is your name, please?
My name is Reuben C. Thomas.
What is your name, please?
My name is Reuben C. Thomas.
All right, panel, follow along with your copies of affidavit number three, if you will, please. I, Reuben C. Thomas, have been driving huge tractor-trailer trucks for the past 8 years. I have driven more than 500,000 miles throughout the country without an accident. This safety record, plus the fact that I once saved a woman's life, led to my recent selection as the nation's Truck Driver of the Year. Signed, Reuben C. Thomas. Okay, once again, you've heard three people claim to be the same one. This time, they all claim to be Reuben C. Thomas, Truck Driver of the Year. Let's begin this round of questioning with Kitty Carlisle.
Thank you, Bud. I've always longed to ask this question, number three. When you're driving along the highway and this great big truck has piled up the traffic behind you 10 deep, is the driver happy or is he unhappy?
I'd say he's unhappy.
That's a very kindly thought. I doubt it. I think he's pleased. He never budges an inch. Number two, briefly, can you tell us how you saved this woman's life?
Well, I was driving in a hill country, and I came over the rise and saw a car coming down the other side with some horses, and she hit the car hit the horse, and I came to a screeching halt and got her out of the car.
Thank you. Number one. They always say that the truck drivers, where the truck drivers eat on the road, is the best place to eat. Where do the truck drivers eat?
At the best place.
Hi, Gardner.
Number one, how frequently do you have to take a physical examination to retain your license?
Annually.
Annually. Number two, what do you drive in your truck? I mean, what's the cargo consist of?
Peanut products.
Peanut products?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Number three, what are the contents of your truck?
Scooby-Day peanut butter.
Peanut, huh? So if you, well... If
what kind of peanut butter?
Peanut butter. You know, when one truck hits the other, peanut butter. number three, I'd like to ask you what truck it is that uses the slogan, the truck that is tougher than the Rock of Gibraltar. Would you know what make truck that is?
No, true.
You know number two?
Yeah.
Number one?
I think it might be Mac.
Uh-huh. Number two, who selected you as the truck driver of the year?
The ATA.
Number three, what is the ATA?
American Truck Association.
Uh-huh. Number two, what was...
Holly?
Number three, what union do you belong to?
As a truck driver union.
I beg your pardon?
Truck driver union.
What union is that?
Truck driver's union.
Doesn't have any initials or anything? Oh, I see. Number two, What is the southern route from New York, the best-known southern route from New York to California?
Well, 66.
Number one, could you name three states Route 40 crosses?
Ohio, Indiana, and Illinois, Missouri.
Number three, what size truck, how long is the truck that you drive?
48 feet.
What type of truck is it?
International tractor and Dorsey trailer.
Is that a diesel engine or a regular engine?
Gas.
I beg your pardon?
It's gasoline.
I said, that's diesel, isn't it?
No,
it isn't. Oh, I'm sorry, I misunderstood you. I thought you said gas. I didn't hear you say gasoline. Number two, well, I got out of it anyway. Really, it's very hard to hear over here.
Thank you, bud.
Oh, nobody believes me.
Number one, what is the speed limit on the Pennsylvania Turnpike?
For trucks, 45.
Is that both for day and night?
Well, it's 50, I believe, and during the day and 45 now, I'm sorry.
I see. Number two, what do you do to keep awake at night? I mean, when you're driving the truck.
Well, about every 3 hours, I drink a coffee.
I see. Number three, what do you do to keep awake?
I sleep.
Number one, going to the Jersey Shore.
I'm sorry, I hate to stop you there, because I was enjoying that nap too, but it's time to vote, so will you please mark your ballots, panel, and vote for number one, number two, or number three. All set? Holly, mark this time ahead. Who did you vote, Holly?
Well, it could be any three of them. I only voted for number one because, he did name three states that Route 40 crosses, and I didn't ask the other two. They all gave very good answers as far as I was concerned. It was just a matter of personal choice.
Okay. Tommy, what about your vote?
I voted for number three because he looks like he does sleep at night.
And Kitty?
I voted for number one on the basis of Polly's question about the roots, and I hope to Lord she was right.
And I got it.
Well, I voted for number three for two reasons. I ruled out number one because that slogan that he thought might be Mack Trucks, I just made it up.
Well, I knew that, but he said he thought it might be Mack.
Yeah, and I voted for number three because he speaks gently and waves a big truck.
Well, there you are. Like him or not, there are our rhymes and our reasons, and we'll find out how right or wrong we are right now as we discover which of these three gentlemen has been selected Truck Driver of the Year. So will the real Reuben C. Thomas please stand up?
Are you sit down? Holly? Sit down. Holly?
Girls, pick up your cartons of Marlboros on the way out. All right, thank you very much, sir. Number one, would you tell us, you can sit down now if you will, would you tell us who you really are and what you do, please?
Yes, I'm Bruce McCamish, a jet pilot and a captain in the United States Air Force.
Thank you, sir. And number two, what about you, sir?
My name is Bob Pointer, and I'm a technical writer for the nice people down at Allied Chemical Corporation.
Thank you. Well, it's quiet here, isn't it, fellas, huh?
Let's start this over again.
Yeah, sure, we might just as well. We've got a whole new show. I wonder whom we'll have next week in those two seats on the panel. I don't know, but in any event, did they get their Marlboros out there? They did? Okay, fine. Well, we'll check the score now and see that there were two incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $500, gentlemen, from Marlboro. Trust you had a good time. We sure had a good time having you here. Good night and good luck. And if the girls have left them, stop and pick up your cartons from Marlboro's on the way out, will you? Good night. Now, panel, I'd like you to meet our fourth team of challengers. All the time we have for tonight. You see, the girls didn't get one right last week or this, and that's why they're kind of dumb. Tom, thanks so much for being with us again this week.
Thank you, bud. You know what they say about fish and guests, so this is my third and last time.
Oh, not the last, we hope. Certainly not the last. Hans Conry will be our guest next week. And I guess that's it. Good night, panel.
Good night, panel.
And now this is Bud Collier saying good night from Marlboro and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
To tell the truth, this is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.